Hi, I'm Robin Whalley. Welcome to Lenscraft. Today I'm celebrating the launch of my new book, Mastering Nik Color Effects Pro 4. And I thought, what better way to celebrate than by completing a demo edit? I'll be showing you how to turn this photo into this. To make my changes, I'll be using Color Effects Pro from the Nik Collection 3 by DxO. But don't worry if you only have an earlier version, as they look and work the same way. The original image was shot in RAW format using a Canon 5D Mark II camera. To prepare the RAW file for editing, I've pre-processed it into a DNG file using DxO Pure RAW. If you're not familiar with Pure RAW, watch my video demonstration. I'll include a link to it in the YouTube video description. My first job with the DNG file is to correct the slight underexposure, which I'll do in Adobe Camera Raw. There, I'm going to start by changing the profile. The reason for this is that I don't like the default Adobe Color profile. I find it can leave some images looking a little bit false after processing in Nik. Instead, I'm going to use the Adobe Neutral profile, which creates a much less colourful starting position. I'll then increase the exposure by around 50. Followed by a reduction in the contrast by minus 20. This creates a nice misty scene, which is a good starting point for editing with Nik Color Effects Pro. Now I won't do anything else further in Camera Raw, including sharpening and noise reduction. DxO Pure Raw took care of these for me, as well as applying optical lens corrections. With the image open for editing in Photoshop, I'll be applying Color Effects Pro as a plugin. To preserve my editing changes for the future, I want to use Photoshop Smart Objects. I can create this by duplicating my background layer and then converting it for smart filters in the filters menu. With the layer converted, I can apply Nik Color Effects Pro to it as a smart filter. Once Color Effects loads the image, then I can begin to add my filters for editing. The first one is the Pro Contrast filter, which I use for a technique I call color cleaning. The filter has an extremely useful correct color cast slider, which I can use to neutralize the yellow color in this scene. This makes it easier to selectively reintroduce color later. I'll apply the effect globally at around 40%, which gives the image a natural feel. The next thing is to balance the exposure across the scene by lightening the ground a little. I'll do this by adding a graduated neutral density filter from the filter library. When I shot this image, I used a two-stop graduated neutral density filter on my lens. The filter wasn't quite strong enough, but the three-stop I had with me was too strong. What this Color Effects filter gives me is the ability to precisely correct my exposure balance, which I couldn't achieve with my lens filters. I'll set the upper tonality to around minus 15, which darkens the sky very slightly. Then I'll set the lower tonality to around 10% to lighten the ground. The blend slider controls the transition between these two areas, and the default of 25% seems fine for this image. But I am going to check the vertical shift slider to see if the transition area needs adjusting. When I move the slider left and right, it moves the transition between the upper and lower adjustments up and down. When I do this, it becomes easier to see the position of the adjustment. The next adjustment I want to make is to better define the castle and hillside. I'm going to do this by adding a second Pro Contrast filter to apply contrast and dynamic contrast adjustments. The contrast slider is the traditional contrast adjustment that makes darker tones darker and light tones lighter. The dynamic contrast adjustment is a little bit different and tends to protect the darkest and lightest tones whilst adding contrast. But what I don't want is for the adjustment to apply to the entire image, so I'm going to use control points to add it to the castle and the hill. I'll then use a few negative control points to protect the surrounding areas from unwanted adjustments. Control points aren't very precise and will blend the filter adjustments into surrounding areas, often where you don't want it. Also, if the effect looks too strong on either the castle or the hillside, I can control it by adjusting the opacity of those control points. When I click the compare button, you can see the difference with the starting image. The next point to address is the mist around the castle and hill. I want the mist to be stronger, particularly on the left of the castle. There are a couple of fog filters I could use for this in Color Effects Pro, but I'll try the graduated fog filter first. This adds a fog effect to the sky, but I can rotate it to cover the ground using the rotation slider set to 0 degrees. Next, I'll use negative control points to punch holes through the fog to show more of the hill and castle. I'm also going to check the different fog methods in the filter to see which one suits this image best. Personally, I like method 3 with this scene. I can then reduce the opacity a little as it's quite strong. After that, I can tweak the opacity slider on the negative control points. By default, the opacity is set to 0 on negative control points, which is what removes the filter effect. When I increase the opacity slightly, you see the fog begin to appear. It only takes a small increase in the opacity to improve the result. Probably my final planned step is to selectively introduce warmth to the scene in the clouds and on the foreground hillside. I'll do this using the Brilliance and Warmth filter, setting the Warmth slider to around 40%. I can then use control points to restrict this to the clouds in the sky. I'm then going to add a second Brilliance and Warmth filter and use that to warm the light on the hillside. Using two separate filters in this way gives me more flexibility to control the effect. I can then fine-tune the filters separately using the warmth and saturation sliders. I like the result to this point, but I feel the top of the frame is a little bit too dark given the light mist in the bottom half. To fix this, I'll add another graduated neutral density filter. After adding the filter, I'll set up the upper tonality to around 40% to lighten the sky. I can then use the vertical shift and blend sliders to control the area of the sky that's lightened. I also want the effect of the filter to be stronger on the left than on the right, so I'll use a couple of control points to refine the effect. At this point, I'm satisfied with the overall effect, but I think the image is a little bit light. To address that, I'll use a levels and curves adjustment. I'm going to start by adding an anchor point to prevent the shadows from darkening too much. I can then darken the midtones, which also boosts the color strength a little. That now looks to be finished, so I can click the OK button to apply my changes and return to Photoshop. Back in Photoshop, if I turn off the layer, we can compare the nick changes with the starting image. What I wanted to do in this video was demonstrate some of the editing potential in Nik Color Effects Pro. If you want to know more, I'm going to shamelessly promote my new book, Mastering Nik Color Effects Pro 4. I'll include a link to it in the YouTube video information. I hope you've enjoyed the demonstration and that I'll see you soon for another video. ¶¶